which means like a led when tambe a kind of the consciousness or mind, something that which is the empty of objective and subjective, that the both object and subject is dissolved, but you know, in the ultimate sense or in the absolute truth, still they believe that there is a consciousness. So the relative truth is this: whatsoever it is illusorily appearing, that they kind of explain as a just a mind. So for instance, like seeing this table, so seeing the table in form of a this substantial and kind of characterized as kind of some shape and made out of like atoms and molecule, that how it is appearing, they say it is the relative truth. It is the in reality there is no substantial, there is no real material existing just as it is, how it is appearing to kind of to this world. So instead of that, if there is no table and there is no substantial, there is no matter that appear as a table, then kind of they say, what is there? From the absolute point of view, it is just the mind aspect, that mind projected in form of table, and mind is projected as cups, and mind is projected as lands and mountains and so forth. Other than that, there is no real substantial kind of phenomenon. So that's why relatively and absolutely they believe that everything is just mind. Other than that, there is no existing any kind of like a substantial matter kind of like a form and existence. So that basically the Namdempa and Namdempa, both who believe the true aspect of true aspect and the false aspect of the appearance of this chitta-matra. So out of that, the first kanti chuba yemena juma kangi mi bar durus kanti chula juma yemena yete chishimi kedi tingi shen namba tene shen namba tene semni yin kanti semni juma kanti semni juma juma na tete kanshi kangi tong jikden jinen gombe jang semji semmi tong she sung Ready so ne rang la rang chidar michu tishini chidar mami rang yung yangda sewar cheshin na mami sewar chamende kanji minji tuba me shel sheshi ngombu ngonyi la shenla tuba yomanyi tishin gashik shenla ni todam teme payang tong ngonyi mila ngombu de tanyi tanyi chaba me marmi sewar chedo she shebe ne shedo chede na lo ni sewa ni yin she kangi shenne tege che Kangsen gai jang tong min na sewa mi sewa moshun pu min jingba chen ten che jang teme to tete rung ri yemin na nam she tembe tembo chidar jur shenyun watan tewe na ten jur chiwe tu shi no ken she tatan temba ni tong che rung ni rab sen na tupe mi me chorwa le bum tung mi min ni jur min chito tong te she watan din nga par cham en din din tung e ju ju ba temba togon to chayin So that is a root verses. Now, based on that root verses, there is the kind of like a commentary. So here explains about the chitta matra, those who believe that the aspects of phenomena is true. So according to them, namripa nares, so that chitta matra, philosophical. Kind of those who enter into that philosophy. Jidhar chinan jungobu nawa jidha ne trasha da minam ji nawa shindu chidundu tembar mejang nangi pakcha ki cheba le nedun lui ki nawa nasubar mimba shikte es te chere chiri ki tenne mejang semni yote. So So in generally, now, based on this, our world, since our world has become so small, so much of interfaith dialogues between so many different religions, including many philosophical, you know, kind of like approach, besides even the science and even the Buddhism. Of course, there may be, you know, so many different ways to, you know, kind of like explain about what is this world, you know, whether it is real or it is illusion, or you know, how it is kind of like existing, and why, you know, there are all these beings, and how this started, when this is going to end, why we just kind of like perceive, you know, in this way, why, you know, majority population of the world just perceive this is as real. So in a way, there may be lots of curiosity and also lots of, you know, kind of like a concept, how to believe, how to understand, how to know. Even you think of yourself, who am I? So why I am here? And when this is started, what is my, you know, previous, is there any my previous or not? Or when I die, what happened to me? Is there any rebirth or no more, gone forever? So that kind of thing, you know, just it's a big curiosity, and also it is so profound in many ways, because nobody could see one's past life, and also nobody can see after the death. And so in many ways, nobody knows what is happening. And also there are so many different religions. They say, you know, if you believe in God, when you die, you will be born there. And lots of people believe. But who knows when they die, will go there somewhere? Or go somewhere else? So, it is a very complicated phenomena, and also not easy to just solve that kind of like curiosity or that question that can be explained in a, you know, just up to date, you know, kind of like this and that. So that is why this kind of the, you know, philosophy, where in one way we say, you know, kind of philosophy, on the other hand, only that somebody who is like, you know, enlightened Buddha can just only know the past, future, and then the present, and then the whole complete, you know, kind of existence, everything, you know, in the ultimate sense. Other than that, nobody can just really know exactly. It's because there is obscuration. You know, so obscuration is like a darkness. You know, when there is no light in this room, then you don't know where you want to walk, and you even don't see the, you know, one step ahead. And that way you just, you know, walk and then step over something and you fall down, and then again, you know, kind of get up and then try to walk or knock your head. All sorts of things can be possible. So it is like a, you know, kind of like a blind person. So enlightened is like that light, when there is the light, and that what is the wisdom, and then you see everything. Similar like that when you have your eyes, you see everything. When you are blind, then you don't know anything. So the samsaric mind is like the blind person. And then the enlightened mind is like that one who have eyes can see. So that is why in the, you know, kind of 12 links of the interdependent origination, that the chart which you see in the beginning, there is a blind person which is symbolizing ignorance. So the all problem is kind of created by that ignorance. So the direct antidote and most powerful antidote for ignorance is wisdom, that transcendental wisdom. So through that transcendental wisdom, then you know, all these explanations are anyway happening. So now here, based on the Chitta Mantra, they're saying, this outer external world, internal living beings, all these matters, whatsoever it is appearing to us, whatsoever, it is all like a completely false and untrue, like a, you know, kind of dream, or like a magician's, you know, kind of creation. That, you know, however we are seeing this, you know, form, sound, smell, taste, texture, and then, you know, phenomena, are all completely like a, you know, kind of illusion. Nothing is really true. So even it is not true and false, like, you know, kind of illusion, then, you know, just how we are just seeing this, and why we are projecting this, and why we are perceiving this is like all everything, what we see, what we hear, what we smell, and so forth, that why we think it is real. So then saying it is just because of the, you know, like beginningless lifetimes, the habitual tendency based on the, you know, kind of like a place, and based on the, you know, place of like a, you know, humans, you know, kind of like a land, and then animals, you know, kind of like a land or place, and then similarly to, you know, God realm, similarly to Holy Ghost beings and so forth, that how they have just projected through their habitual tendency of this, you know, kind of place. And similarly, that the projection of, like, you know, kind of the sound, is that form, sound, smell, taste, texture, it is all also just the habitual tendency that which is projecting. And then similarly, every individual form, like we born as a human, human's kind of habitual tendency that, you know, kind of projecting that we have a human form. And similarly for animals and so forth. So all sorts of various kind of being, you know, kind of like appearing just because of that habitual tendency. So in reality, there is no any, you know, all any of this substantial or matter or that atom, that dust, that which composes all this kind of form, taste, smell, and so forth, that there are nothing is ever existing, but still there is, you know, kind of mind or consciousness that which has been kind of like as one project, then it appears as a form or sound and smell and taste and texture and phenomena. For example, like, you know, in the dream, when you have a dream, then in your dream there is a landscape, there are people, there are, you know, kind of like you are having a party and you are eating something, you know, you are just hearing music and so forth in the dream. There are all those five sense objects. It looks like all everything so real. sometimes some dreams are very, very clear, you know, very, very vivid. It really feels like a real. Even when you wake up, you have the whole complete memory of that scene of the dream. It looks so real. But when you wake up, it looks real, but that whole complete landscape, people, and you know, everything never ever just existed. Never ever existed. It is all just kind of like a rabbit's horn. Rabbit's horn? Rabbit and horn. Yeah. I'm thinking if I have a horn. Yeah, rabbit's horn, you know. So you all hear the translation, right? Good. Yeah, those who understand English, then it's okay. Those it's still English plus need, you know, that your own language to make it more clear. So anyway, like a rabbit's horn. So what means rabbit horn? Is there any rabbit horn? Never existed. But still we can say rabbit horn. So similar like that, this whole complete, even Chitmantra also said that it is all just, you know, kind of like a false, like a, you know, kind of dream. But then why this all appearing? Because that mind is there. Mind is in form of table, mind is in form of cup, mind is in form of this, you know, kind of chairs and you know, house and cars and computers and so forth. All it is just mind aspect, mental aspect. And that which appears like, you know, kind of table. So the appearance of table as a matter, as a composition of the dust or atoms, that what it is, you know, kind of false, relative truth. So absolute truth is that it is just only the mind. So that what it's saying, only mind, only philosophy, chit matra. So milam naya ngoso ge nyam nyam ngoso ge nyam nyung zimbar tube. So nyam du nyam some days. So in the dream, you know, we also have the experience of, you know, kind of having that dream, like a, you know, like green flowers and then, you know, peoples and so forth. So then now they are refuting to the, you know, kind of like a Matemika philosophy, because Matemika, moreover, this is the, you know, Prasangika, Sautantrika Prasangika, Uma Tenjuba is Chandrakriti, and then, you know, Ajar Shantadeva. So they say, right now, it is all like illusion. Nothing is, you know, kind of real. It is all, you know, emptiness without any elaboration. So that's why now they are arguing or refuting to, you know, Matemik. To Uma Patana, Kanti Tube Yu Chidu Mebar Mathes, Tube Loyang Yoba Mina, Yul Tumatovo Kangi Mibar, Yu Tumatovo Kangi Mibar, Yu Tumatovo Kangi Mibar Durs, Mibar Dute, Yuji Mebeso Sena, Rishi got to be on the chate. So that for the Matemika, they are arguing, according to your this Matemika philosophy, that you are saying that the external phenomena, there is nothing really existing because it is all, you know, kind of emptiness. And since it is emptiness, doesn't have any inherent existence or inherent true nature. So whatsoever it appears is like a dream and like a, you know, kind of magical illusion. So there is no external. And similarly, that internally, you know, the Madhyamika, you say that there is no, even that, you know, mind, that, you know, kind of, even the deluded mind is also not existing, because how the external phenomena are emptiness and never existed, in that same way, the mind is also emptiness and never existed, according to the Madhyamika philosophy. So, Tuvelo Yumina. So, you Jumadava Gangimi Banju. So, since you don't have subjective mind, which is also completely illusion, there is no mind. So how you can perceive even like a illusory phenomena? So in this way, they are arguing to the, you know, just a madhyamik, the chitmatra, they are arguing or they are refuting. So now, then the madhyamikas in a kind of philosophy like Chandrakirti or like, you know, here, Shandadeva just saying, Kandisem tamba chola chumadu yu tondu tuba menas, teze lo yu tu sinjang mikja chishi mikdes, mikja yulda, mikja yujin nile, kanyaruwa mena, mikbar misibe sos. So now, the, you know, just Madhyamika, that they are very smart. So they are just kind of like a questioning similar to how they question to them. So saying for the, you know, mind only, you know, you all mind only believe. For you, even that, even like, even illusory kind of like this form and sound and so forth is not existing. So then, even though you have this, you know, kind of, because they believe that there is the mind is existing. So what that mind can just really, you know, kind of perceive, because there is no any, you know, illusory form that you can just, you know, kind of really, you know, perceive it. So that to be perceived the objective and that to be, you know, perceived by the subjective mind, if there is, you know, either one, whether it is object or subject, either one is not existing, then it cannot just kind of say there is an object or there is a subject that can be perceived, you know, in this way. So then how you are going to just, you know, kind of like understand? So then kelde taja luglas you then never mind it. So then the chitta matra, they are saying no, it doesn't mean that we don't have this, you know, objective phenomena, because they are saying milam ke talan chindu yu tenje kosa tinye tu ten pembole shendu jurbe migja shik yedos. So similar like this, you know, when the magicians create, you know, like horses and doggies or humans and so forth, you know, like which is, you know, kind of like illusion. So similar like that, the Chaita Matra, they are saying, you know, on this, you know, kind of objective phenomena at that, you know, spot, even though there is no matter or atoms or inanimate substance, that which appears as tables and chairs and houses and cars and so forth, but you know, but other than that, there is something that which is to be, you know, kind of like appeared. So then what is that? You know, just you can just perceive those objects, even there is no any matter at all. So te kanchana yu jiren shu do nawe sungwe ge namba den semyi inji tene mainos. So whatever the, you know, objective phenomena, you know, that illusorily you are perceiving, you know, at that there is the, you know, just mind. There is the mind aspect, that which appears in form of, you know, kind of table and, you know, cups and, you know, cars and so forth. So that was why, you know, for the Chidmatra, for us, even it is illusion, but still we have that, you know, kind of mind that just substitute to appear as, you know, kind of form, sound, smell, taste and texture of all these, you know, kind of substances. So, my no chenas. Kandesem yini mikja chuma tavi tuen yina, tezi yu kanshi yujin kangi tonte. So then, the Chitta Matra, again they are going through, you know, kind of dialogue. Chitta Matra, you know, say something, and then the Madhyamika now kind of like a, you know, arguing or going through dialogue, that thing. Okay, so to say, you know, for example, like to say in this house there is a table. So then to say that, you know, you must have to perceive that table. Without seeing the table, you cannot just, you know, say that, oh, there is a table. So when there is a table object, then there must be a subjective mind. So that there cannot be existing a single object and single subject without, you know, kind of corresponding to each other. So that's why they are saying you kanchik yujin gangi thondes. What kind of object can be perceived by what kind of, you know, subjective mind? For that day, then there is a, you know, kind of asking that the Madhyamika now refuting their, you know, argument. If that way, because you are saying the objective phenomena is also mind, and that which is perceiving, and that is also a subject mind. So the, you know, Madhyamika say, oh, that is not possible, because both are mind. So both are mind, mind cannot just kind of perceive. So, you know, then they say, why that mind cannot perceive? The Chitta-mata saying, arguing, you know, why mind cannot perceive the mind? Chitta-metunyamna. So then first that the, you know, Madhyamika saying, the protector of this world, the enlightened Buddha, also said that mind cannot perceive the mind. And then, you know, how that is, you know, kind of possible that mind cannot perceive that mind? Then Buddha also gave, you know, example saying, Radisu rangiramichu, the, you know, the sharp knife, how much that sharp it may be, it cannot cut itself. And similarly, this, our, you know, kind of like fingers, how that, you know, just, however this finger can be, you know, kind of like straight or anything, that the fingertip, itself cannot touch itself. Not possible, you know. Similarly, all those gymnastic players or circus players, they have, you know, kind of very flexible body, and they could do, you know, just all sorts of, you know, kind of like a twisting their body. As even this modern world, like there are, you know, kind of kids or, you know, kind of boys and girls, they do all sorts of this with one hand dancing and just jumping up and jumping, flipping back, and so many things, you know, all sorts of, you know, sometimes street shows. So however their flexible body may be, they cannot ride on their own shoulder. Not possible, you know. Shumbha Miniva Tishindu, similar like those example, that a mind cannot just perceive mind itself. And not only that, in the sutra Buddha said, which is called Tsungna Rinpoche Ndoles, Jitate Penna Rediso Dingye Rediso Dingye Chowa Minibadang Sumu Sormitimu Dingye Sumitimu Larewa Minibadi Shindu Sim Dingye Sinyitwan Miniso Shesungso. So in this the sutra, which is called the precious jewel on the crown, there is one sutra. In that explained with this, you know, kind of like example, and said that a mind cannot perceive mind itself. Similarly, that the eyes, you know, our eyes can see all the object, but eyes cannot see itself. So you know, with all those, you know, kind of reasoning, they, you know, to refute the, you know, there's a Madhyamika refute that, you know, just you are saying that mind, you know, mind, mental aspect, you are just seeing it.